Let's say, first we'll talk about an importer, okay? Later we'll talk about an exporter perspective. See, money market hedging for foreign exchange is very easy, provided you are able to understand the concept and why which particular step is taking place and from where to where we are going. If you are able to follow the sequence of steps, money market is so goddamn easy. But students usually try to remember it as a formula based or else as a structure based, as a steps, as they want to by heart a step. Step 1, step 2, step 3. Don't do that. Use your logic. Use your common sense. This concept becomes so goddamn easy. Okay. First of all, importer. Okay. Let's say ABC company is there, which is a UK based company dealing with pounds. Okay. Now, what they did is they have imported some goods. Imported goods. From XYZ company in US. Okay. So basically what will ABC company have now? They are exposed to a dollar payable. They are exposed to what now? Dollar payable. Sir, this though we already know. Okay. Now let me tell you how exactly it works. Okay. Imported goods worth $10,000. Okay. At 3 months time. That means they have to make the payment after 3 months. Okay. See, simple logic is, if I am making the payment today itself, will I have any foreign exchange risk? Absolutely no, sir. Why? Because I am making the payment today. There is no chance that the dollar to pound rate will increase or decrease in the future. I am not worried. I am making the payment today itself. Okay. Sir, but to make the payment, I don't have money. So from where will I get the money? Okay. See, use the logic here. That is where money market comes into the picture. Okay. Money markets offer you a short-term fixed rates of interest. Borrowing rate and lending rates will be available. Okay. Both borrowing rate and lending rates will be available. Now, what this ABC company has to do is, remember, in money market, we always go with reverse flow. Sir, what do reverse flow means? See, we have, after 3 months, I need to pay $10,000 to a US based company. After 3 months, I have to pay $10,000 to a US based company. Okay. So, I want to reduce my risk to zero. See what I am going to do. Very carefully see what I am going to do. I am going to invest in US money market. So what? Okay, listen. The situation is that rates of interest in UK, borrowing rate is, let's say, 4%, and lending rate is, let's say, 3.5%. Okay, or else borrowing rate means, okay, let's keep it as borrowing rate. Lending rate, I'll keep it as a deposit rate mark. So, if you make a fixed deposit into some bank or something, they'll give you 3.5% interest. If you are borrowing from the bank, they'll charge you 4% rate of interest. Okay. And similarly, in US, let's say borrowing rate of interest is 5% and deposit rate of interest is 4.2%. Okay. This is just random numbers given to you. This may or may not be the actual scenario. Okay. Sir, what are you trying to tell us? Listen to me very carefully, then only the steps will be very clear. So, what is your present situation, ma? First, exposure is, after 3 months, you have $10,000 payable. So, you need $10,000 after 3 months. So, let me make a deposit in US today itself. So that what will happen after 3 months, this deposit will mature and I will get US dollars. I will make that payment of US dollars to XYZ company
So I'm not worried about the foreign exchange risk. Okay. So how much shall I invest in the US money market today, sir? How much should I invest in such a manner that after 3 months it will become exactly 10,000?
What? Today I will make some investment in US money market so that after 3 months it will become exactly equal to 10,000. Sir, how do you know how much you need to invest today? We know the US deposit rate is how much? 4.2%. So I will make some deposit in such a manner that along with interest it will become 10,000. So how much will that be, sir? How much do I need to invest? We know how to calculate present value of money. Yes, we know how to calculate present value of money. So what is the rate of interest, ma? 4.2%. This is per annum. So how many months do we need? 3 months. So what we will do, divided by 4, correct? Yes or no? So rate of interest is equal to 4.2% into 3/12. So how much will that be? I know the calculation, I just wanted to make sure that it is correct. Okay, 1.05%. Now what we will do is, we'll invest in such a manner that total will become 10,000 after 3 months. Okay, so present value of 10,000 will be how much? PV, future value divided by 1 plus r whole power n. Do you remember? So that is 10,000. We want 10,000 in the future, divided by 1.05%. That is 1.0105. Correct? 1.0105. So how much will that be? 10,000 divided by 1.0105. That is 9,896. So if I deposit today $9,996 in the US market, if I give them $9,896 today, after including the interest, after 3 months, it will become exactly 10,000. Calculate 9896 into 4.2 into 3/2. 9896 into 4.2% into 3 divided by 12. That is how much? 4.2 into 3/2 is 1.05, now, okay. 9896 into 1.05%, that is 104, okay, plus 9896. So total will become exactly 10,000. Clear? Clear, ma, or any doubt? Okay, sir. So basically what we are doing, we are investing in the US market today. Today, how much are we investing? 9,896. Okay, sir, fine. So by this step, what will happen? We have exactly enough dollars in our money market investment so that after 3 months, we will be able to make the 10,000 payment. Sir, but the problem is, how do I get $9,896 today? How do I get $9,896 today? Let's say the spot is £1 is equal to $1.2. Okay, today we are assuming that £1 is equal to $1.2. Okay, sir. So what I need to do is, I need to first gather enough pounds to convert them into $9,896. Accepted? Okay, how many pounds do I need? $9,896 I want. So how many pounds I need? 896 divided by 1.2 gives me around 8,246.66. Okay, let's round it off to 8,247 pounds. Sir, what is happening? Okay, see, if today I have 8,247 pounds, sir, from where we will get? I'll talk about that later. Assume today I have 8,247 pounds. What I'll do, I'll convert this into dollars. How many dollars will I get? I will get exactly $9,896. Correct?
$9,896. Then what I will do? I will invest that $9,896 in US money market at 4.2% per annum, making it 1.05% for 3 months. So after 3 months, along with interest, this investment will become $10,000. Correct? That $10,000 will be paid to XYZ. Okay, sir. All this is clear. But from where do I get this £8,247 now? From where do I get that? Borrow. Borrow this £8,247 from US, UK market. Okay. Borrow £8,247 from UK market on the spot. Okay, sir. At what rate will be able to borrow? UK borrowing rate is 4%. UK borrowing rate is 4%. Okay, so I'll have to pay 4% interest. Okay, sir. So what will happen? See, when I borrow 8,247 at 3 months time, for 3 months time at 4% per annum, which is equivalent to 1% per 3 months. Correct? Yes or no? 4% per year into 3 by 12 if you do, that is 1% per 3 months. Correct? For that quarter. Okay. So now, what will be the amount after 3 months? What will be the amount after 3 months? Come on. In 3 months time, along with interest, how much do we need to pay? 8247 into 1%. Correct? So that is £82.47. So total will become how much? Total repayment at 3 months time is equal to how much? 8247 plus 1%, that will be pounds 8,329.47. Okay, sir. Sir, why are we doing all this nonsense? Let me tell you. First, let me complete the sequence. Okay. Sir, okay, fine. All this is fine. Last step. What is the last step? So, when you invested in the US money market, you will get that return. So, how much will you get, ma? Interest. 9,896 into 1.05%. That will be how much? 9,896 into 1.05. We already know that 9,896 into 1.05%. That is $104. So total will become $9,896 plus $104. That will become $10,000 after 3 months. Right? Repay $10,000. At 3 months time to the US company. Sir, why are we doing all this blah 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 steps, sir? Okay, imagine now if dollar to pound rate after 3 months became, now it is 1 pound is equal to 1.2. After 3 months it became 1.5. Do you have any effect of that? Are you concerned about that? No, not at all, sir. Why, sir? Because you don't have any more foreign exchange exposure. You have already entered into a position where you will have exactly how much you need after 3 months. So this position is entered as on today itself. So no matter what happens with the dollar to pound rate, whether it will become 1.5 or 0.8, you are not at all bothered. You have exactly enough foreign currency to settle your exposure. Understood? You are having exactly enough foreign currency to settle your exposure. Okay, so what is your exposure now? You just have a borrowing of £8,247, which is in your own home currency. Sir, I don't have money. Okay, that's why you borrowed the money. So what is happening here because of this is you have completely eliminated your foreign exchange risk. You just have £8,330 payable after 3 months. £8,330 payable after 3 months. That's all. You have pounds payable now. You don't have anything to do with dollar. You don't have any exposure for foreign currency. Remember, ma, money market hedging is the perfect hedge. Is the perfect hedge. You know, if you are entering into forward, there is a risk for you.
right? The forward rate might increase or decrease. You are having a variable payment to be made. Your payment to be made is fixed according to the contract, but your gains or losses might variably change. Futures, again, not perfectly hedging is not possible because there will be interest risk involved in the market. And when I go to options, again, you might exercise the option, you might lapse the option. But when I'm talking about money market, my exact outflow is perfectly fixed today itself. My exact outflow, irrespective of what happens with the market, my outflow is perfectly fixed today. I don't even need to worry about the market in the first place. Understood? I hope you are able to clear. Forwards also will have the same concept. Now, under forward options also, your liability is fixed with the banker. Absolutely fine. But still what happens is you will have foreign exchange gains or losses to be calculated. But in case of money market, you don't have any foreign exchange gains or losses at all. At all. Because every settlement is made today. Anything to do with foreign exchange is completely closed today itself. We are only having home currency payables or home currency receivable. I hope I am able to explain you clearly. Right? So, I am switching to notes only mode. So, take a screenshot of this or copy this particular explanation. Then we will go forward and we will take the steps. Okay? So, copy this complete steps. Okay, let me just first take the steps as well. So, what is our first step here? Can somebody tell me what is the first step? Borrowing money in the home market is the first step. Converting that into dollars is the second step. Investing in money market is the third step. That money market will mature and the payment will be made to the supplier in the fourth step. And in the fifth step, we will make the payment to our lender. Whoever, from whomever we have borrowed the money, to him we will make the payment. Right? Copy this down very fast. Come on. Clear? Good. Chalo, let's move forward then. So we got all the concepts clear now. Now let's copy the steps very quickly. So money market hedge steps for importer. Money market hedge steps for importer. Okay, what are the steps for the importer? First step, borrow in home currency. Borrow in home currency. Sir, how much do we need to borrow? Sufficient money in such a manner that the payment can be made. Okay, let me write it like that so that you guys will get exact steps. Okay. First, exposure is equal to forex payable, correct? You have an exposure to make the foreign exchange payment. So step two, what we will do is calculate present value of liability using forex deposit rate, ma, not borrowing rate. And next one, third one, deposit the PV in forex market. So to deposit this money, what do we need to get? We need to borrow in the home currency using spot rate. Borrow in the home currency using spot rate. So how much amount we have to deposit? That you calculate by calculating the present value. That you convert into the home currency by using the spot rate. And that much money we will borrow in the home currency. And once we borrow in the home currency, last step is repay borrowed home currency at expiry date or at due date with interest. And deposited in forex that will mature
and liability set off. Right? So these are the steps involved in money market forex hedging for importer. So first, what are we having an exposure position? We have a foreign exchange payable. So what am I supposed to do? Calculate the present value of the foreign exchange payable by using the deposit rate in the foreign market. Then what I'll do, sir? I'll convert that into the home currency by using the spot rate. Then what? I'll borrow that much money in the home currency using the current borrowing rate in the market. Then what? After the expiry date is done, my deposit here will mature and that amount will be used to settle my liability. My liability here in the home currency will mature and I will settle that in the by using the in along with interest to my home borrower. Clear? All good? Sorry, lender, not borrower. Sorry. Clear? Any doubts? If you have any doubts, you need to text me on WhatsApp, right? Okay. Chalo.